I've spent 42 years in construction, and for 28 of those years, I've worn a Sears Diehard mock toe wedge crepe sole boot, usually 8-inch top. I got hooked on those boots because of the value and because of the sole. The sole never wore out, but the stitching often wore out. So now that Sears is dead, I had to do something different. So the boot that I'm reviewing in this video is Carolina's 8-inch wedge crepe sole mock toe work boot. And the reason I'm reviewing a Carolina boot is because Carolina was the first company to send me anything. 3 years ago, when we were just fiddling around with YouTube, Carolina sent me a boot. Now, I picked a Wellington slip-on, but Nate picked a mock toe work boot. He's got 3 years on these things. He loves them for reasons that I'll talk to you about in a minute. But, you know, he got them pretty well worn out. It was time to get a new set. He went with Carolina's.
I'm sorry to interject like this, but I have to point out that my work boots are not worn out at all. They have a ton of life left in them. Now, they are worn, but they feel like a slipper when I wear them, and I am not getting rid of them anytime soon. I got the new pair so that I would have a cleaner, tidier pair if I needed to look a little more well put together. But so far, they've just been in the box, and they've been there for 6 months now.
So before I draw one more breath, let me kind of give you a spoiler alert right now and tell you that I like this boot. I'm impressed with it. Okay, now with that out there on the table, let me give you some of the reasons that I have sort of decided that this is pretty darn good. But before I go through that list, I've got to acknowledge that almost everything that pertains to boots is determined on the same sort of criteria that we use to identify our sports teams or our pickups or our cordless tool line, whatever it is. It's almost always preference, isn't it? It's tied up with aesthetic, and it's tied up with tradition, and it's tied up with brand loyalty generally. But boots are a tool. At least I have always considered boots to be a tool. And so tools have different characteristics, and this particular tool, boot, has some characteristics that I like. So when these things showed up and I pulled them out of the box, you know, I liked the look, I liked the color, I liked, you know, the appearance was pleasing. But when I lifted them up, I thought, whoa, that's light. I continued to have that impression every time I put them on. They're light, they don't weigh much. So that comes with some sort of red flags, right? If they're light, maybe there's not much material in there. That's not my conclusion. But the next thing that I recognized was when I pulled these things on, there's an insole in there that's soft, the toe box is wide, and they felt good from the first time I laced them up. Now, I've got kind of a narrow foot and a narrow ankle, and so the diameter of the upper was just right. It didn't close up on my skinny little, you know, canary ankles. There was still room to adjust them and tighten them up. And putting them up is facilitated by speed hooks. These have got speed hooks up and down the sides, three of them, three pairs, instead of eyelets, which are slower and wear out your laces. So I've always been a fan of speed hooks on my cork boots, and I continue to be a fan of speed hooks on my work boots. One of the things that I like, I can't help it, I like it, is they're made in the USA. And in some cases, that's nothing more than marketing, right? But not in this case. As soon as you grab these things, the leather kind of sticks in your hands and make you think, yeah, that's a piece of cowhide, man. That thing is going to stand up. You look at it again, you realize this has triple stitching everywhere that it is even remotely going to be necessary. That's good, because I have been used to having some stitching fail. So one of the things that is a reality for my work boots is I do a lot of concrete. And concrete does the same thing to your boots that it does to your hands. And that is, it dries them out. It sucks the moisture out. It'll make them crack and split and dry out. But a higher quality leather stands up to it better, and these guys have been taking the abuse pretty well. I've never paid too much attention to boot laces except to replace them when they wear out. You know, in the fabricating shop, the welding BBs burn through your laces, and yeah, they're burning through these laces a little bit, but these are a smaller diameter, more tightly woven lace, and they're just tougher than what I've been used to. So I'm getting more wear out of the lace, I'm getting more comfort out of the boot. They are, I think, a better than adequate substitute or replacement for what I've been doing all these years. And so far, the only downside I've found is they cost more money. Let me talk about the sole on this thing. It's great because it's got plenty of gription, right? And it's non-marking, and it doesn't track mud into the house with you, and that's important when you're walking in on Mrs. McElhenney's carpet. But there is a downside, and it's the same downside that every other major boot manufacturer puts on their crepe sole boots, and that is they wear out. The upside is this quality upper can be resold. So you can get, you know, some number of soles put onto this nice quality upper and you're even, right? I mean, you get all the characteristics that you need while you're using them. It just goes away a little quicker, a lot quicker than what I was used to with the now extinct Sears Diehard boot. You know, I think that's the only reason they could ever get away with calling it a diehard is because the soles died hard. You know, preference in boots is not just about the style. Preference in boots is also about the function. And I prefer an 8-inch top. Nate prefers a 6-inch top. The case for me for always picking an 8-inch top if I can is, first, it keeps the dirt out. It seals up around the top of my, I mean, it gets way up above the bottom of my pant. And so when I'm down in a, you know, crumbing out a footing or, you know, climbing around on a pile of gravel, I'm not getting sand and gravel down into the top of my boot. And I mean, that's miserable. Who likes that, right? And then the other thing is, it grips my ankle. It's support. I mean, I don't have to be worrying about rolling my ankle when I'm climbing around on the trusses or walking on the joists. It just makes my, it ties my foot to my leg, and that's a handy thing in construction. Nate prefers these because lighter, like I said, but easy on, easy off. It's just bam, in, out. They work great. He doesn't worry about his pants hanging up on the back because his pants, I wear shorter pants, okay? But the short ones work good for Nate. The 8-inch works good for me. It is, of course, whatever works good for you. And so as I wrap this up and before I start putting a long overdue coat of Hubbard's boot grease on these things, I just want to say that everybody likes a different boot and you've all got good reasons. So make a comment, will you? We've heard about a lot of different brands and the reasons. And the reasons are more important to me than just your attachment. So if you can give me a reason, that makes your comment valuable to anyone who's looking to make a decision. A huge thank you to Carolina. They said I get one more pair for free. And at my present velocity, that'll probably be about next spring when the spec house is done. So I got to get busy and lube these things up if I want to get all the good out of them that these tops require. Because when you get leather that beautiful, I mean, look at it. You could wear that to dinner, right? That's a good looking shoe. It deserves to have a little better care taken of it than I tend to take of my foot gear. Thanks for watching, Essential Craftsman, and keep up the good work.